Hello everyone, this is Dr. Nadir Bakhari UB. I secured 289 rank in 64th BPSC examinations. So let me introduce myself. I did my graduation in BDS from AMU and thereafter I pursued Masters in Public Health from TISS Mumbai. I worked for an year in a corporate setting in Mumbai itself and then I came back to academics. I qualified JRF and I am pursuing my PhD in Sociology right now. So my optional was sociology. So a natural question arises from many of the aspirants that why sociology, is sociology good, is it scoring, and many other pertinent questions. So I'll try to discuss all of these questions in a brief manner today. So first of all, why sociology? Now if you ask me why I opted for sociology, then I would say that I had an interest in sociology because when we were at TISS, we were exposed to a lot of social issues and social matters. We attended the foundation course where we were taught in detail about many of the pertaining social issues in the country. So a part of my interest arises from there. And the next thing I did was I read the NCERT books. They are a very good guide to know what your interest area is. So I was confused initially between political science and sociology. So finally I opted for sociology and I thought this would help me as I was pursuing my PhD in sociology as well. So the other question is that what to follow, which book to read in sociology, or is sociology a good optional? Now if you ask me in a general sense, no optional is good or bad. The marking in optional depends on what you have written, how you have represented yourself, how you have carefully presented the answers with their nuances, with their different dimensions. So, is sociology a good optional? I would say yes, because if you are preparing for UPSC, I was an aspirant of the UPSC, I wrote the 2017 mains and after that I wrote the BPSC prelims. So, if you ask me, I would say that yes, sociology is a good optional. And this is an advice especially for all UPSC aspirants who are now trying to attempt for the state examinations. UPSC is a good option because you get an added advantage. In UPSC, you can attempt questions in GS paper 1 and 2 as well. And in BPSC also, you can attempt questions in the general studies paper as well. So, because see, most of the general studies paper would somewhere ask a question related to social issues. So you would have a grip on the social issues. So sociology can help you over there as well. Now, what to read in sociology? That's a very basic question and that's a very confusing question as well because we have a lot of matter, a lot of literature, a lot of content available in the market and it gets really difficult to judge as to what to read and what not to read. So I opted for Herlambos and Holborn. That is sometimes called as the Bible of sociology. This is the most basic book which has very detailed concepts, very relevant examples. Now an issue arises is that this Herlambos and Holborn does give you basic concepts, but when it comes to the Indian context, you may have to read a few books which are different and which are more aligned towards the Indian context. So for example, I read Yogendra Singh for Modernization of Indian Tradition, A.R. Desai. You can read Caste by Surinder Jodhka, that's an excellent read. Like if you see the 64th BPSC Sociology optional paper, you had a direct question that define the caste system and the problem it presents in redistributive justice. Now this is a very multidimensional question. First of all, you have to be clear about what is caste system, what are different concepts presented by different thinkers and different sociologists. And after that, you have to proceed to the existing scenario or the current scenario. So you will have to read Herlambos and Holborn. You will have to read a few other books. And see, you don't have to read the whole book. You go through the syllabus. You see what parts are relevant. You read only those chapters. Because if you are attempting to read all the books, it's a waste of time. You won't remember anything. And when you don't remember anything, it gets difficult to write in the examination. So confine your approach, go for the books, but just read the relevant chapters. For that you will have to need to go through the syllabus first. So go through the syllabus, see what are the relevant chapters in the different books, and then go for it. Like you have a book by Ghanshyam Shah on Indian social movements. Now if you see the syllabus of UPSC as well as BPSC, they don't mention all the social movements. So you have to sort out which social movement you have to study, and then you read only the relevant chapters. Now many of the aspirants ask as to which paper to follow, which magazine to read if you want to. See, if you ask me about the paper, I would recommend The Hindu. The Hindu, especially the Sunday magazine part, they usually have the review of a book, and if the book is somewhere related to your topic, that review helps a lot, and that also somewhere underlines the current trends, the type of literary matter which is being written, the type of sociological trends which are in flow. So that would help you. And even in the normal days, if you read The Hindu, you would get many topics like democracy. Democracy is a very often repeated topic in the optional subjects, like especially in political science and sociology. So for democracy, you have different views, you have different authors. If you are reading The Hindu regularly, you would get many dimensions and you would get a lot to write about. If you ask me about magazines, I would say you can go for EPW, Economic and Political Weekly. That's a very good magazine. You can go for the Frontline as well, but I would recommend you follow EPW. EPW is a magazine of high impact factor, and very carefully crafted material is present over there. So The Hindu, EPW, these books which I mentioned, these are all, I think, sufficient for your understanding. I had an added advantage because I was pursuing my PhD in sociology, so I had knowledge of a few basic things already. So that helped me, and I studied in detail many of the topics, and I scored a decent 166 marks in sociology. So that is about the books, the references, the magazines, the papers you have been asking about. Now, how to start for sociology optional? See, for any optional, you have to start somewhere. If you are confused as to which optional you have to choose, go for the NCERTs. They are the best guide to know whether you have interest in something or not. And after that, once you have decided that you are going for a certain subject, if you are going for sociology, I would recommend Herlambaugh's and Holborn. That is the most basic book that would help you get the concepts, grasp the concepts in a very detailed manner and in a very lucid manner. Now, does reading newspapers help? This is a very common question asked. Many of them said that we can have PDF available in the market. See, you can always have PDF available in the market, and there are many authors. A lot of content is already available in the market. But see, you are trying to be an officer. You are trying to be in a post where you want to influence the lives of people. Now, this is not an easy and normal task. You need to have a vision. You need to have a perspective. You need to have clarity of thoughts. So that is what exactly what the paper does. The paper gives you new perspectives and new dimensions. So you should read PDF. I won't say that you should not read PDFs, but if you read the newspapers, that's much, much better. So now a question which is asked by many aspirants, some of them who are preparing for UPSC and also attempting BPSC, they ask that how to find a balance between the UPSC and BPSC sociology optional. See, the basic remains the same. In BPSC optional, you have a few other topics which you have to cover. Otherwise, the basic course is same, and you can always work with your preparation in UPSC and align it towards BPSC. So now another question is that how do we write the answers? See, writing answers is a difficult task, and it should be a continuous task. Then the abilities also vary. Some of us are good at writing, some of us don't have that good writing skills. So in that case, that is not something to get demotivated. You can always practice. You can write answers every day, and writing answers gives you an idea about how you have to maintain a flow, how you have to frame your sentences. So answer writing, yes, is a basic and essential process of the preparation part. You should definitely write answers and get it checked by your friends and teachers and your guides and mentors. So all of that helps. So sociology needs a very holistic approach, And one important thing you need to remember is that in sociology, you have to relate the current affairs to the static part. Now, most of the questions which are asked are somewhere related to the static part, and you have to quote examples from the recent advancements or the recent changes. So you have to carefully analyze the static part and then try to introduce examples from the current affairs into the static part, and that is the best strategy to get good marks. I followed this strategy and it helped me a lot. So I think I have sufficiently talked about what needs to be done in sociology and how good it is an optional. So I wish the best of luck for all of you who are preparing for 65th, 66th and 67th BPSC, and we hopefully will connect later. If you have any queries, we can always be contacted on DKT. So take care, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.